A ladder 24 feet long, leaning against a wall. The lower end is moving away at the rate of 3 feet per second. Find the rate at which the top of the ladder moving down. If the ladder of the its foot is 8 feet from the wall. Write down the question. A ladder 24 feet long, leaning against a wall. Okay. So this is one ladder. This is one wall is there. This is one wall is there. So here I'm taking one ladder. So wall ladder will be. So what is the how much? Is a 24 feet long, and this is a meter is 8 feet from the wall. Is 8 feet. What I'm doing here, I'm pulling here. If I pull here, what happened? That wall, this it will be increasing and height will be decreasing, correct? So I'll take it as this is X and I'll take it as Y. X is increasing, Y is decreasing. In our differentiation, if I take it, I can call as dx by dt. How much is decreasing? I think 3 feet per second is decreasing, correct? Dx by dt is decreasing. 3 feet per second. Why dy by dt? Why I'm taking dy by dt and dx by dt? It's a decreasing by small quantity. What you are seeing that this is a very, very small quantity. That's why I'm taking in the approximation. So dy by dt is decreasing. How much? You're going to find out. How to find out here? I have x will be 8. X is equal to 8. And the given 24 meter ladder is there. How to find out y? Anyone tell how to find out y? Can I go to Pythagoras theorem? What is the Pythagoras theorem? X square plus y square is equal to 24 square. Correct? Is it a formula? X square plus y square is equal to 24 square. How to find out 24 square? I last time I thought the how to do square also. 4 square will be 16. 2 4 is 8. 8 2 is 16. 8 2 is 16. 16 plus 1 is 17. 2 square is 4. 4 plus 1 5. 5 76. Shortcut. Remember, you are for you competitive. For the finding the any two number digit square, you can do easily. 4 square, 16, carry 1. Next multiplication, 2 4 is 8, 8 2 is 16, 16 plus 1 is 17, carry 1. 2 square is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5. So 576. Okay, now x square. What is x square will be? What is x square? So apply sin x. Why a sin x here? No need, na? Okay. Now, what is x square? I'm going to find out x. I have y value. X value I know 64 plus y square is equal to 576. Now, y square is equal to 576 minus 64. Y square is equal to 576 minus 64. How much you get? Tell anyone. 512. So, y is equal to square root of 512. Is there no need to simplify or you want to simplify? Simplify. No problem. So 512, how we do? 512, it will go with the 2. 2 4 is 2 2 is 4. Is it, I mean, 2 5 is 2 6 is. Next again, it will go 2. 2 1 is 2 2 is 2 8 is. Next 2 6 4. Next it will go 2 3. 32. Next it will go 16. It will go 8. It will go 4. It will go 2 2. So make it group. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2, 2 is a 4, 4 is a 8, 8 is a 16. 16 root 2. I can write as 16 root 2. Okay, this is the y value. Y value is it be 16 root 2. Now, I'm going to differentiate now. What is that? X square plus y square is equal to, x square plus y square is equal to 576. Now, differentiate. Differentiate with respect to t. What is the differentiate with respect to t if I do? Why I'm doing t? Because I'm going to differentiate with respect to time. X square differentiation, what happened? Dx by dx by dt. Correct? What is the y square differentiation is 2y dy by dt. Is equal to differentiation of 576 is 0. Because it's a constant. Now I know x, I know y, I know dx by dt, substitute. 2 into what is x value? 8. Dx by dt, they given 3. Plus 2 into what is the y value? I got it 16 root 2. Dy by dt, I'm going to find out. Dy by dt is equal to 0. So what the answer will be to 8 is 16, 16. So I can take it 16 common. If I take it 16 common, what is the remaining here? 3 plus root 2, 2 root 2 into dy by dt is equal to 0. 16 is not possible, 0. What is the remaining? 3 plus 2 root 2 dy by dt is equal to 0. So dy by dt is equal to, what is the answer will be? Minus 3 by 2 root 2 is the answer. I'll repeat once again. The length x of a rectangle is decreasing at the rate of 5 cm per minute and width y is increasing at the rate of 4 cm per minute. When x is equal to 8 cm, y is equal to 6 cm, find the rate of change of perimeters and area of a rectangle. So what they given data? Dx by dt is equal to minus 5 centimeter per minute. 5 centimeter per minute. Dy by dt is equal to 4 centimeter per minute. And x is equal to 8 centimeter. Y is equal to, what is the y they given? Y is equal to 6 centimeter. What do we need? Perimeter I need. Means the rate of perimeter means dp by dt I need. The rate of change of area I need means dA by dt I need. This is both are question mark. First question. Perimeter. What is the perimeter formula? Write down. The perimeter of a rectangle. What is the perimeter of a rectangle? 2 into L plus B, correct? But I'm taking here X plus Y. Reason, X and Y is the length and breadth they given. That's why 2 into X plus Y. Now find out dP by dt. Differentiate with respect to t. Why negative, sir? Negative means what did the decreasing they told? That's why negative. So dp by dt is equal to 2 into x differentiation is dx by dt. With respect to t, I'm doing. Why I'm doing t? Because they told per minute means time. So that's why I'm doing with respect to t. Dy by dt. Now, 2 into, what is the dx by dt answer? What is the 2? Dx by dt will be minus 5. Dy by dt it will be plus 4. What is that? What is the answer will be 2 into minus 1. So minus 1 will be minus 2 centimeter per minute. This is the answer. Write down. Try for area. Area is equal to length into breadth means x into y. Try to do dA by dt. Finish this writing. Next, A is equal to x into y. If you know differentiation only, application of differentiation you will understand. Otherwise, it's difficult. dA by dt is equal to, how to do differentiation? XY, how to do? Minus 20. Why minus 20? X into differentiation of y will be dy by dt plus y into dx by dt. I'm using UV rule. Keep it x as it is, differentiation of y will be dy by dt. Plus keep it y as it is, differentiation of x will be dx by dt. Okay. Now, x into, what is the x value? They given 8. 8 into, what is the dy by dt value? 4.
6.
6 or 4?
6.
X is 8, dy by dt will be 4. Y is equal to 6, dx by dt will be minus 3. Y will be 6 and dx by dt will be minus 5. What is this answer? 32 minus 30. 32 minus 30 will be 2. Area is they given. Area, what is the unit of area? Is it centimeter square per minute? Because area unit will be centimeter square. So centimeter square per minute is the answer. So if we reduce by, suppose if I take the rectangle, if I reduce it by 2 centimeter height, width if they're reducing, if they're increasing y width, so how much area change? 2 centimeter per second, that much area will change. Okay, that's the question. Finish, you want to explain? If you want to explain, put in chat box, I'll explain. Okay, next question. This question will repeat once again. March 2015, what I'm telling, the question number is observed, question number 43. Yes, a particle moves along the curve. Please explain, sir, once again. Okay, write down this question, I'll explain that. Anyway, I'm doing recording also. A particle moves along the curve, 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. Find the points on the curve at which the y coordinate is changing eight times as fast as the x coordinate. A particle moves along the curve, 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. These are all questions what I'm doing in exercise 6.1 is there. Check it once again. Work out all 14 questions. In exercise 6.1, you have 14 questions. Work out all question number 14. You'll get it 15 marks confirm. A particle moves along the curve, 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. Find the points on the curve at which the y coordinate is changing 8 times as the as fast as the x coordinate. Okay. Now, next question. So what they given? 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. This is the one curve they given. They what are they? This is a given part. And they told dy by dt is equal to, it's changing x coordinate. Changing means it's a, with respect to time it's changing. That's why I'm taking dy by dt. Don't take it y is equal to 8 times of x. Don't take it. It's a changing. That's why they given. We are taking. That's why dy by dt is equal to 8 times of dx by dt. Now, so 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. We need the point means we need x and y. I'm going to differentiate. Differentiation of y with respect to t will be dy by dt. Differentiation of x cube will be 3x square dx by dt. Plus 2 will be 0. Now I have dy by dt will be 6 into 8 dx by dt is equal to 3x square dx by dt. Now what happened? Dx by dt cancel. What is the remaining? 3x square is equal to 6 8 is 48. X square is equal to 16, x is equal to plus or minus 4. I got it, x is equal to plus or minus 4. Now I want to find out y value also because they told coordinates. So if x is 4, what is the y value? Y is equal to 6y is equal to 64 plus 2. So 6y is equal to 66, y is equal to 11, means 4 comma 11. If x is equal to minus 4, if x is equal to minus 4, what is the answer? 6y is equal to minus 64 plus 2 because cube is there. 6y is equal
64
to
64 or 24?
4 cube, what is, how much? What is it? 64?
Okay, 4 cube. Okay, sure.
So minus 64 plus 2 will be minus 62. So y is equal to minus 62 by 6, it means minus 31.3. Correct? Yes, minus 31.3. So answer will be minus 4 comma minus 31.3. What is the points are? Points are 4 comma 11 and minus 4 comma minus 31 by 3. I'll repeat once again. They given here 6y is equal to x cube plus 2 and dy by dt. Dy by dt is changing 8 times of dx by dt. They given. These two are they given data. Now I'm doing what they're given curve. I'm differentiating with respect to t. 6 dy by dt is equal to 3x square dx by dt. I know dy by dt value will be 8 into dx by dt. Substitute 6 8 of 48 and 3x square dx by dt. In the both side dx by dt is there. Cancel it. So 3x square is equal to 48. So x square is equal to 48 by 3 will be 16. X is equal to plus or minus 4. If x is equal to plus or minus 4, if x is 4, what is the y value? I'm going to substituting here in this question. So what is the answer I got? 64 plus 2 is 66. Y is equal to 11. So 4 comma 11. If I substitute x is minus 4, 6y is equal to minus 64 plus 2. So minus 62, minus 62 by 6 is minus 31 by 3. So that is the point. Okay. Next question. Question number 43. Next question paper. One confirmed 5 marks. What I discussed from 2-3 days, 15 marks ilantina 5 marker only. Question number 39, 40. See this question number 39, you know how to do. 40, you know how to do. 41, you know how to do. 42, 43. 5 questions here only. Okay, this is important. So many times this also repeated. A sand is pouring from a pipe at the rate of 12 cm cube per second. The falling sand is from a cone on the ground such a way that height of the cone is always 1/6 of the radius of the base. How fast height of the sand cone is increasing when the height is 4 cm? This, when they read the question, is looking very complicated. But when you do the sums only, it will very easy. A sand is pouring from the pipe at the rate of 12 cm cube per second. The falling sand form a cone on the ground in such a way that height of the cone is always 1/6 of the radius of the base. How fast is the height of the sand cone is increasing when the height is 4 cm? So feel difficult, but when you do the sums only, feel easy. So here one pipe is there. So here
so these pipe questions in textbook in which exercise are there, sir?
Exercise 6.1. So here one cone, one pipe is there. What happened here? Pipe, sand is pouring. The sand is pouring. What happened here? Ground, one cone is formed. One cone is formed here. So what is that amount will be? This is the height they given. What they given, height is 4, correct? And what they given, 12 cm cube per second. What is 12 cm cube per second? Anyone tell? Anyone? What is it? What is 12 cm per cube second? Is it dv by dt? Based on unit only you can guess, because it's a volume. Cm cube means the volume. 12 cm cube per second is a volume. Next. Height is equal to 4 cm they given. Next, what they given here? The height of the cone is always 1/6 of the radius. Means h is equal to 1/6 of radius. Means is it r is equal to 6h? Correct? Radius is equal to 6h. Okay, now what is the volume of a cone formula? Tell me anyone. What is the volume of a cone?
Square h. One by three pi r square h.
Very good. 1/3 pi r square h is the volume of a cone formula. So here, when I'm doing differentiation, I can't, because two variables are there, radius also, height also. So that's why I'm converting to one variable, either in the form of h or in the form of radius. So v is equal to 1/3 pi into what is the r value? I have 6h. R square value will be 36 h square into h. It means v is equal to I got it 1/3 pi, 36 h cube I got. Now I can cancel 3 ones, 3 twos. It become v is equal to 12 pi h cube. Is that now for this do differentiation? Differentiating with respect to T I'm doing. Now to dv by dt is equal to 12 pi into, what is h cube differentiation? Is it 3h square into dh by dt? Is it 3h square into dh by dt? Now, I know I have dv by dt. What is the dv by dt? Will be 12 into 12 pi into 3h square. H value I know. H is 4 into dh by dt. I'm going to find out dh by dt. I can cancel 12 is become 1. So dh by dt is equal to 1 by 3 4 is 12 pi. Correct? Huh? Anywhere write it wrong? H square, no? Become 16. Yes. 16 3 is 48. 48 pi centimeter per second is the answer. I'll repeat once again. What is this? Okay. So they given the one pipe, they given sand is pouring on the ground, it make the cone. Okay. Dv by dt. How would you know if they're not mentioned anywhere dv by dt? Based on unit only you can find out. Cm cube per second means it's a volume only. So h is equal to 4 centimeter. Now h is equal to height is 1/6 of the radius. They only given. So I found by using this equation, I found r. R is equal to 6h. I know volume of a cone. Volume of a cone. Practice 2-3 times. It will get 1 by 3 pi r square h. Now v is equal to 1 by 3 pi. Two variable are there. R also is there. H also is there. I don't want two variable. I need one variable. Either in the form of R or in the form of H. But I need answer in the form of H. So that's why I don't want R. So R value I'm substituting 6H. If you differentiate with respect to T, what happened? You get two variable. dr by dt also will come. dh by dt also will come. One equation, two unknown is very difficult to solve. That's why make it one unknown here. Okay. So R value will be 6H. 6 square H means 36H square into H. It become V is equal to 12 by H cube. Now differentiate with respect to T. dV by dt is equal to 12 pi. H cube differentiation is 3H square dH by dt. dV by dt will be 12. 12 is equal to 12 pi. 3 into H square. H is 4. H square is 16. Into dH by dt. Now, 12 cancel, it become 1. So I need dh by dt, everything I'm sending denominator, 1 by 48 pi is the answer. This time 2020 also this question came 5 marks. So many students, they don't know concept, they're doing. If you're in the exam, if you write data, 1 mark you'll get. If you write this formula, 1 mark, 2 marks. If you write here till here, 3 marks. If you write fully, 5 marks. Unit is not a matter, but if you write dh by dt, 1 by 48 pi, you get the answer. Some students, they'll remember answer, they'll forget this and something they'll miss up and they'll write the final answer only. This is they remember answer because this is important question. Okay, next question. Next question paper. 2016 March, this question paper little here and there, because question number 43 maybe is not come. Question number 42. Yes, this question is there, 42. I think you can try. We did same type question. If you want, you can take your time and do it. Now only, I'll wait. Same sum we did. No, we didn't do same sum.